I have a question, Sensei.
Yes, sir.
We have seen this past year several people we thought, or at least I thought, were very devoted to Jodo Shinshu leave. But in particular, there was one that was a member of the Jodo Shinshu Sangha for many, many years. My question is, not only how, but why would people go through the motions of faking this practice and go through even years of pretending to be a Jodo Shinshu Buddhist, only at the end to just abandon everything? And it's just something I'm curious about. And we've talked about it, you've explained it to me, but I just can't wrap my head around why you would go that far into the Sangha, even to the point of training for the priesthood, only just to leave at the last minute. I'm curious.
I don't think there is any need for us to know what is in their head, you know. But I don't think we should stress about it or ask why. I don't know. And you know, I don't think these people faked it. I mean, perhaps they were well intended. Perhaps they had good intention. Perhaps they themselves thought that they have Shinjin, until one day they realized they don't have. You know, Shinjin, you either have it or don't have it. So once you have Shinjin, you can't lose it. But many people can have enthusiasm about Jodo Shinshu. They can have knowledge about Jodo Shinshu, because Jodo Shinshu is not a difficult path to understand. Especially if you come to Amida-ji and listen the Dharma through Amida-ji, then Jodo Shinshu will look very simple. If you go to other denominations, other branches, then things might be difficult for you, because there are not so simple explanations like we have in Amida-ji. People are more complicated than us, you know. I met with many people in other sanghas who didn't understand anything from what the priest taught or the scholar taught in various conferences at European meetings. So those guys at those meetings might think they don't have Shinjin because they don't understand anything. But people who come to Amida-ji, they can easily understand the essential of Jodo Shinshu. So they might think they have Shinjin, I don't know. But later, they will realize they can't actually entrust totally to Amida. They realize they need something else to beside the primal vow, beside Nembutsu. So that is the sign when you realize somebody doesn't have Shinjin. When he starts to feel the need to add something beside the primal vow, when he's not satisfied with Nembutsu only. So this is what I think. Perhaps they were well intended. Perhaps they were sincere, but one day they realize they don't have Shinjin. But what our attitude should be like this. We should treat these people, we should behave like a mirror. You know, a mirror always reflects what is in front of it. And it is filled with the image of the person in front of it. So when somebody comes to our Sangha and asks for the teaching, we should give it. We should try our best to help that person, have a friendly attitude, and be a good companion on the path, and reflect him in our mind. Think on many ways how we can help him, but when he decides to leave, then we should just let him leave. A mirror doesn't reflect an object which is not present in front of it. See? So we should be like a mirror. When people leave, we don't care. We don't complicate our minds with that. It doesn't matter why. What is important is that we don't have anything to, how can I say it in English? We should not have anything to reproach or to complain about ourselves. So we should know that we did everything we could for those people. And we didn't make any mistake while they were here at Amidaji. And at least we helped them to make a connection with Amida Buddha, with the true teaching. And that is enough. Perhaps later in another life, this will help them a lot. The seeds of true Amida Dharma were already planted in their mind stream. And sooner or later, they will become more open to Amida. But until then, it's not our problem. It's their problem and Amida's problem. This is what I think.
Thank you.
If you guys want to say something, please do. This one.
No.
I don't even remember how many people came and left since I became a priest. A lot of people. you know, and because we are so strict with the Dharma, because we are so orthodox with the Dharma, many people will come and leave. If we were not so strict, if we said everybody can come, no matter what they think, no matter what they say about the Dharma, then we would have a very large community here, like other temples have. Why do you think many other temples have so many members? Because they offer yoga classes, karate classes, bazaars every Sunday, because they have many cultural events, like in Echo House, for example, in Germany, because they say that everything is Buddhism, and because they don't care about the doctrine. So, but we are not like them. We want people who are not decided to follow this path to don't come here. Or if they are here, we want them to leave. You know, we don't want to keep people here, but only serious guys. Mm-hmm. Renyo Shonin said, the power of our school does not rest in many gatherings of people, but in only one person receiving faith. So, mm-hmm. We don't want to be popular. when there are too many people, we should ask ourselves, what is wrong with us? You know, there are too many people who like us.